but you're still going to get turned around regardless.
Right. And either way, that's not a good situation for you at all.
Yeah, and you don't want to sacrifice your stock, especially right. in a big tournament like this. Like, even if you have the high damage and he has the low damage, you want to use that rage right. as Ganon.
Ignoring this advantage, though, I feel like in neutral, Ganon, surprisingly enough, might actually have the tools to contest Mario, given his really good range on his normals and relatively fast options in his jab and down tilt. He can definitely have the tools to keep Mario away uh-huh. at a good spacing.
And Mario's up tilt. It's just really dangerous for Ganon. But already see that. Two moves, yeah. 42%. It took Mario four moves to get 29%. So
absolutely.
Ganon with damage as well is really dangerous. Good shield grab. So Ganon, compared to me, has a lot more grabs and a way better neutral. And especially he's going to throw out a lot of down tilts as well. Mm-hmm. Down tilts are really powerful with
Ganon. Absolutely. And you'll see that A1 is constantly going for a lot of the down throw up airs and trying to get Ganondorf off stage into a bad situation. He's trying to bait out the air dodge. Ganon's Slam being very smart and not taking the bait.
Ooh, and good jump away. Because that up smash is dangerous and is lagless. So he can do a lot, and there's the air dodge.
That time Ganon Slam does indeed air dodge. He has to watch out for that. A1's been baiting those the entire game so far, and he's going to continue doing
it. Up smash.
Beautiful up smash. A1 DI-ing pretty incorrectly there.
Yeah.
Getting that stock taken at like 98%. Let's go, Ganon.
Against Mario, he can combo you a lot, but he puts you in that rage advantage, and Ganon having that rage advantage is incredibly terrifying, and you just saw that with that up smash. Just even at zero. That up smash can kick you
Mario. So Ganon Slam going from 0 to 100 real quick and now starting to get a little bit of damage packed onto him.
And that was a solid tech by A1. That side B is really dangerous on stage if you don't tech it. Good fireball.
Very good.
And good job using. Ooh.
Oh, that was bad.
So
that might be it. See, Ganon's not taking the bait this time. Good for
him. So both Falcon and Ganon have the ability, and that's going to take it.
Yeah.
So Falcon and Ganon both have the ability to use their side B to insta-snap to the ledge.
Uh-huh.
It's just more dangerous for Ganon because if you're down a stock.
Yes.
That.
What? A Toon Link?
Twitter.
No, I don't.
Okay. Yeah, they're putting in their Twitter.
Oh, okay. That's
the commentator's
cool.
names. When you're down a stock and with Ganon being able to insta-snap to side B, uh-huh. it's actually going to prioritize the person if they're on the ledge rather than the edge itself. Falcon's the same where he'll actually hit the side B with his flame fist instead of grabbing the ledge. So you have to be careful with your side B trying to insta-snap. You want to make sure they're not on the ledge with you.
Right, otherwise you could go down. Mm. However, I believe that Ganon does win the game if both are on the last stock. So
yes, completely.
That could be very advantageous.
He's the only he has the only suicide move in the game, so Bowser has one too. But like, it's the only one that he kills the opponent first.
That's incredibly useful and definitely something for A1 to watch out for. Ganon Slam counterpicking the Lylat. I'm actually very interested by his pick. Do you have any reason for this?
So the reason for Ganon and Lylat is because most players, especially most people, will think that Ganon hitting the wing right here will kill him. And it will if not done correctly. If you hit the middle of the wing right on the ledge and you hold back, you will grab the ledge no matter what.
So basically he has a bit of an advantage when it comes to recovery compared to other characters, what you're saying.
It's because Ganondorf has the best ledge grab game in the game.
Like
he has the best magnet hands, basically.
Okay.
Good
that was very
grab.
Good pivot grab.
Going up for that up tilt.
Ganon Slam fiending for the up tilt. I think right now Ganon Slam in a bit of a deficit. He's looking to get something going. He has his jump. He might be able to make this back.
And that was barely. Good. That was good. Not using his jump when the flood came out. But unfortunately, just going to get that A1 going to get that roll read and get that up smash.
Excellent coverage from A1. I believe he just reacted to it, considering it's slightly.
That was a smart read, just unfortunately spaced incorrectly by Ganon. Because there's a lot of damage that you can do with that forward smash on roll read.
And up smash. That up smash will take it.
There it is. It is dangerous.
You see A1 tapping his nose saying like, oh, I knew that was coming out. I was smelling it. He wasn't ready for it, though.
You can smell it. And it does so much shield pressure. And Ganon is one of the best at shield pressure.
Absolutely.
Oh, this is dangerous.
He's not going to air dodge because Ganon is a smart boy.
He's a smart
boy.
There we go. And Neutro is one of Ganondorf's strongest moves. That was a good jump.
That was very risky.
Because if he neutral get up or rolled, he would have actually died.
Fascinating.
Yep. So there's a lot of people. When you're maining Ganon, you don't have a lot of tools.
Right.
And so you have to use the little tools that you have, and you have to be patient. Patience is key with Ganon. If you're too aggressive like that, you're going to get punished for it.
Yeah, Ganon Slam got a little bit greedy at the end. I understand why, considering how far down the deficit he was, but it definitely cost him the game.
Yep.
A1 taking it 2-0 over Ganon Slam.
And
to A1.
And Greg showing that Mario is not a huge threat against Ganon, but it's still a threat.
Of course.
And it just like any character that's high, when you're playing a low tier against high tiers, you have to expect that the character as well as the player you're playing against.
High stream.
High stream. Is just going to know better.
Definitely agree with you.
To what to do against that character. There's not a lot of options that you have.
I completely agree with you on that one. It's just a matter of learning what tools you have to deal with what situation and then trying to build some kind of a plan off of that. Low tier is definitely one of the best tools. Genesine did really well for the first stock, but A1 adapted very quickly near the end.